Today we'll be reading the poem of actress Amber Heard. There will also be a link in the description for the written article of our poem reading, the text version. So be sure to check that out if you prefer text over video. So the first thing I noticed from her hands was that the fingers did not have well-developed first phalanges, which show a lack of interest in academic studies. So when I read her biography afterwards, I found out that she has not studied that much, that she was mostly like, I think she earned her GED at home. So she is very less studied academically. She also did not have any training as an actress, which I also assumed from her lack of first phalanges development. So it didn't come as a surprise, just surprised me how accurate palmistry can be. Then we see that the most developed phalange actually is the second phalange, which shows that she is very good in the material world. She is a money maker. She is a person who, if she does not get the opportunities, she will go and get the opportunities. Even though she comes from a small town and she comes from a very middle class background, but she went for the high life. So from a small quiet town girl to a blockbuster star, what does she have? So basically she has a very good headline. If you see, it's like this. Now what this headline gives is, because one fork is going here, the other fork is going here, so it gives a lot of, what you say, logic, which is shown by the straightness, and imagination, which is shown by the line going downwards. Now interestingly, if we see that the time this line is going downwards, it is in the 30s. So at that time, I think, yeah, in around 2015, when she was 29, she got married to Johnny Depp, and then this relationship lasted from 2017. If we see that when the headline goes downwards, it denotes two things. It denotes that, especially when it becomes like almost a double headline, more like a very strongly forked headline, it does show that the person improves themselves, and that when it goes downwards, the person, whichever career they are in prior to this headline emerging, it means that they will be more successful because they will be adding creativity to that. If we see that around the time this headline also has a drawback, that when this headline occurs like this, the person has a lot of relationship issues even throughout life. If the headline overall is like this, which he has had, like she has a lot of breakups. And we also see, but the most turbulent relationship for her was in this era of 2015 to 2017, which denotes the early 30s, as shown by the headline, because this is also the area of depression. Sometimes, it depends on the overall hand, though I would say that overall she has a very strong hand. She is, she does have sensitive padding over the fingers, but that is just for the early part of life. The overall hand, it shows a very, a woman who doesn't care what other people think, basically, later on. But in the start, yeah, it's a very sensitive. If we see the fingertips, they show sensitivity. But the overall hand does not show sensitivity as such, because it is very strong, a very strong palm that the person doesn't care. So let's also look at her fate lines and sun lines. Now, basically, her sun line is coming from the Mount of Moon, which denotes, as I've said, that the sun line from here is not one of the best sun lines, because it denotes because anything coming from the Mount of Moon, it does not assure success. It means suppose you're like an advertiser and your ad only gets approved, like you work for an ad agency, your ad only gets approved when the client is satisfied, even if you've done all the hard work in the end. Sometimes you do less hard work and then you even get more returns. So the person's career is very on and off, especially in the terms of acting. Like 90% of actors will have their sun and fate lines from the Mount of Moon. So what happens is that basically the person's career depends on the approval of other people, and acting is, the box office success depends on the approval. First, the casting is determined by the agent, then the casting director, then the director, then the producer, etc. So it's a long process, but on each and every step there is approval. So so whenever I see this kind of fate line, nowadays we have a lot of people with this fate line and sun lines from the Mount of Moon, because life has become very digitized. So everything is on more approval basis. Like, it's not like, the old days when there was less competition, you study, you get the job, etc. Like in some positions, for a doctor, accountant, and some very hard, like the positions where you really have to work hard, you might not have found people with this type of headline, but even there, I have found many doctors with this type of headline, which denotes success in the country away from the country of birth. So I'm just saying this headline can be shown on anyone, but mostly it's shown on the people like who have an on and off career. And even acting, like, no matter how much the money the person is making, like you see Kevin Spacey, one wrong move, career ended. So yeah, so as I said, it's a very on and off headline and sunline. But still, we see it getting very strong around the 35 or 36 mark. So basically, it is getting very strong around the mid 30s. So I would say at 32 itself. Actually, what happens is usually with people from the sun or headline from Mount to Moon, it means that their 20s are very, very, what do you say, on and off. Like suppose there's a person in their 20s, they're doing multiple jobs, they're maybe freelancing. They're freelancing, but in five different areas. They're doing multiple things and they're making good money. But the thing is, they themselves want one job and, you know, to earn from one job enough not to do many jobs. It's not like, you know, because that shows a bit of, I would say they're still financially stable. They will be well off, especially coming from a well-off background. She herself comes from a, like, what do you say, not a super financially well family, but her dad owned a small construction business. So you see, she doesn't come from. Like the overall hand also doesn't show, you know, those lines of poverty and stuff. So we see that the people with the fate line from the Mount Moon, their 30s are very well settled. Basically, their 30s will see a rise of life or show a lot of stability. But their 20s will be very on and off. So that is a big issue with these people, that some of them don't survive their 20s. Like they go into acting, they're cast into side roles again and again, and they quit. And it's understandable. Then they maybe become acting teachers, instructors, or just do what their non-acting degrees were in. So we see a lot of people who, especially if you see any person, like if they're starring as an extra, if they're starring in a minor role, like, you know, sometimes appearing in this show, that show, that show as a minor character. So these people will also have equal lines like this. The only thing which separates them would be that there might be some special star mark or something, or that it was just, you know, it was just luck overall. Like if someone like her, she has the fate line from, sorry, the sun line from the Mount Moon. If you go to another person who is not as successful as her, and because she has risen in her at her 32 age when Aquaman released, it grossed $1 billion. So that is when, you know, her career skyrocketed. So, but in her 20s, you will see her appearing in various movies, sometimes independent movies. You see where I'm going with this, that people with the sunline, anything from the Mount to Moon, the Fate Line Sunline, will be, you know, on and off phase. Like sometimes they will be having a success, like with Never Back Down. Sometimes they will be having a flop film, like with Drive Angry. So this is a very, like, the person themselves has to be very strong if they want to survive in the industry, because it's very, very competitive, and there are also other things like a lack of fame leads to problems. Fame leads to problems, so that's where her hand is very strong, and we'll go to that, because if you see, it's not overdeveloped. We see here that it's not overdeveloped. Oh yeah, going back. So why is the sun line rising from the middle hand and becoming very strong here? Because now she is more grounded. Now she is more financially stable, because we see. Like now after Aquaman, like Aquaman will have sequels. She is confirmed for the sequels, and maybe even like movies, like where, you know, spin-offs, or maybe even another Justice League, etc. So she has a role which she will be known for. Like, oh, this is that woman Mira who was in Aquaman. Before that, she was appearing in so many multiple roles. You'll be like, oh, that's the woman who was in Never Back Down. That's the actress. Who was in All the Boys Love Mandy, and so she was known for many things, but the fame was split. So here we see that the fame will be continuous. We also see that what I think will happen with her is that later on, because we see at in the 50s, the sun line is pointing towards the Saturn line, which both are very strong. So this means that in her 50s, what will happen is that basically she will again get a role, maybe most probably in a series which will last for many, many years. Like she will be known for that. Like she will be cast in something. It could also be two things, because we see a Saturn and a Sun line. But this shows consistency, because when the Sun line goes here, the Saturn finger itself stands for consistency. We also so that just means that in her 50s, she will be cast in a permanent role somewhere, which will, like, you know, those soaps which go on for 20, 30 years. So she will have a very, 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 what do you say, permanent role from there on. So this is all for palm reading to know more about her and also her compatibility with Johnny Depp, read the article below in the description. Thank you so much for watching and have a very nice day ahead.